Coming up, we make the intelligent edge real by showing you how you can leverage IoT in secure, intelligent ways, starting with a look at the new Azure Digital Twin service, how to secure devices at the intelligent edge with Azure Sphere and the new development kit, easy ways to apply intelligence on data from your IoT devices with Azure Cognitive Services, new options for managing your IoT devices with Azure IoT Central, and how you can apply serverless, event-driven automation on the edge. So I'm joined again today by Jeff Hollan. Welcome, Jeff. Good to have you, buddy.
Thanks so much. It's good to be here.
Yeah, no stranger to Microsoft Mechanics.
Yeah.
Now, we've been hearing a lot about IoT and the work that Microsoft's been doing in this space over the past year, and I know that you yourself are an early adopter of the technology, but for those among us who are waiting for the technology to prove itself a little bit more, how real is it today, and what are some of the applications that you're seeing?
Yeah, so it is very real, and you can see this kind of every day in our lives with things like home automation, but it's really starting to take off in the industry too. So what we've set out to build here in Azure is an entire IoT platform that not only allows you to take advantage of those connected devices on the edge that can send data back, but one that also adds device-level security with things like Azure Sphere, lets you reason and analyze on the data coming from those devices with Stream Analytics or Azure Databricks, applies intelligence to get predictive insights using machine learning and cognitive services, letting you manage the health of those devices with IoT Central, and of course, even kicking off serverless automation or workflows with services like Logic Apps.
Right, so this platform approach offers a lot of convenience for people. You're not having to source a lot of different services and implement and manage your own IoT ecosystem. And I imagine this puts IoT within the reach of organizations everywhere.
Yeah, it really does. Really, any smart device that's connected to the internet can start to leverage IoT. So let me make this real for you. I have this example. On my phone, I'm actually running an application from one of our partners, CBRE. And this is built on top of the new Azure Digital Twin service that was announced today. And this application enables organizations to create a digital twin of a physical space so that they can optimize how that space is being used. So what's powerful here with this app is you'll notice I can actually use this to get some work done, whether I need to have a meeting or find where someone's working. Now, I want to have a meeting, so I'm going to select this option, and I can even come down and choose the devices that I want for my meeting. So in this case, I say I want a Surface Hub, I want a Skype meeting room. Now, once I apply this search, you'll notice here the map of my building. Some of these rooms are lit up green, some of them are lit up that they're occupied, and in fact, over here, it's actually recommending that I have my meeting in this amber room. I can actually click Navigate here, and using GPS on my phone, now I have turn-by-turn directions to this room. Now, this is awesome because it's not just leveraging the scheduling information, it's actually pulling real-time data from the physical space, which is extremely valuable for a scenario like this where I want to find a conference room, but you can imagine this might also be nice if I need to find where someone's working.
Exactly. It looks incredibly useful, being able to see in real time your choices for finding an appropriate and available space for your needs. And I know we've all been in similar situations, some of us at the conference here as well. We're visiting a new building, struggling to find a free space to work. So how does this actually work under the covers?
Yeah, so the digital twin graph has been set up and is used to model the physical space because there's various devices that are going to be feeding into this real-time perspective across the entire environment. Now, the digital twin service enables us to virtually model the relationship between people, places, and devices that all coexist within a physical space. And what's great about the Azure IoT ecosystem is that it's entirely open, so you can utilize any smart device and include it in it. So you can imagine you might have a simple pressure sensor on your chairs to know if a seat has been occupied or not.
Right, so you can basically use IoT devices in this example to get a full real-time view of the current work environment, whether I'm looking for a workspace or I'm in facilities and want to know for space planning perspectives, or if I'm in a device in sensitive workspace areas. How do we make sure that these are all secure and they can't be hacked or compromised?
Yeah, so one nice thing about Azure here is that we've actually approached security of IoT from a few different angles. So first, when it comes to the management of these devices, all of these services and apps are backed by role-based access control. Now, what that means is that only the right people with the right permissions can make changes to any part of the system. Now, next, it's really important that you have secured communication to your device. You need to make sure that your device is who they say it are. And to prevent things like a man-in-the-middle attack, IoT Hub enables a number of ways for you to securely communicate with your device, including certificates, so that you can encrypt and sign every message that's being sent and received. Now, finally, Azure can actually provide security even at the silicon level. So Azure Sphere is a new solution for creating highly secured microcontroller units, or MCUs, and power those devices where security now starts at the silicon level.
Right, so help us understand Azure Sphere a little bit more. Is it a piece of hardware specifically?
Yeah, so Azure Sphere is actually a three-part solution. So it includes this MCU, which is a tiny single-chip computer, but it also has an operating system and a cloud security service. So if we start with the MCU, these are about the size of your thumbnail. And MCUs are found in everything. Over 9 billion new MCU-powered devices are built and deployed every single year. And more of these are starting to have connectivity built in. So we actually have an Azure Sphere dev kit up here, which we'll show you in just a second. But this Azure Sphere was just released and based on our over 15 years of experience of building hardware like Xbox. Now, Azure Sphere MCUs are a new class of MCU where security is just built in. Now, this isn't just a processor. This has memory, connectivity, compute, and it even comes with secured isolation using our Pluton subsystem so that we can store private keys. Now, what's cool here is that on top of the hardware is the Azure Sphere operating system. Now, this operating system was purpose-built for IoT security, and it includes isolation at the OS layer so that your system layer is completely isolated from your application layer. So even if you had a malicious application code that was on your device, it's unable to gain access to those secured elements of your device. Now, the last layer is the Azure Sphere security service itself. Now, this is a turnkey cloud service that guards every Azure Sphere device. And it does a few critical things. It can broker trust so that communication is always certificate-based and authenticated. But it can also detect emerging threats across the entire IoT ecosystem. And then using that knowledge, it can then improve security through software updates to ensure that devices stayed secure even as the IoT threat landscape might evolve.
Right, so who's Azure Sphere really for then?
Yeah, so any manufacturer who's working with MCUs today and they're interested in connecting to the internet should think about how they can use Azure Sphere to improve their security story. Now, what's great is that we have these dev kits, and they come with everything you need to get started, and they're available starting today. So we've actually got one here up on stage. You can see I've got this USB cable. It's plugged directly into my machine. So now I can start to build applications to power this. So here on my screen, I actually have a very simple Azure Sphere application. What I want to be able to do for our office is have a secured light switch to turn on our light switch over here, our light bulb. So in my solution in Visual Studio, I've been able to write this code. It's really simple. I'm just looking to see if the button has been pressed on our light switch using Azure Sphere. And if I detect that button's been pressed, I will go ahead and encrypt and send a secure message out to IoT Hub, which will be relayed to our light switch here. Now, I'm going to cross our fingers that this all works out. I've deployed this to our Azure Sphere-powered light switch.
Yep.
So Matt, if you don't mind, go ahead and give us a nice press.
We'll press your button in 3, 2, 1.
Okay, he pushes it, and right away, there we go. The light switch is turned on, that secure message sent to the cloud, and turning on our office light switch.
The sound effect I gave was optional as well. That didn't come with the ad. I don't know why I went into autopilot there.
I enjoyed it.
And as, I hope we'll all agree, a very enlightening demo, Jeff.
Come on, you've got to appreciate that. Yes, enlightening demo.
Now, because this was built with Azure Sphere, we can be confident in knowing that nothing else can turn on this light switch or this light bulb apart from this specific light switch. And this is going to remove a major blocker for using IoT devices in the enterprise. Now, we also mention the intelligent edge a lot. So what is that that makes these devices intelligent, and how are we able to harness it?
Yeah, so this is where it gets very cool, and this is actually my favorite part. Because hopefully we're all aware of the massive leaps that machine learning and artificial intelligence have made over the last decade. But this next exciting wave that Microsoft is leading is around just what you talked about, the intelligent edge. And the idea here is that you actually run the analysis directly on the devices themselves, whether those devices are online or offline. And you're just leveraging the cloud to help build and train those models.
So that seems like it's going to be able to process faster and work with or without internet connectivity.
Yeah, exactly right. This is what we mean when we talk about the intelligent edge. And it's especially important for scenarios where every millisecond matters. You could think of a factory line. You might have machinery that has sensors and machine learning running on those machines. Well, if there's a problem with one of those machines, you need to act on it right away. You can't deal with any extra latency that sending a message out to the cloud might bring. Not to mention you could be saving massively on egress charges from having to push all of this data over the internet.
Right, so that all sounds great, but what does it take to bring that intelligence to an IoT device? Does this mean I need some background in machine learning or advanced mathematics?
Yeah, so I'm actually going to show you how you can build one of these today. If you think back to our conference room scenario, what I want to build is a solution so that if there's a conference room with a camera in it, that camera is smart enough to know if a person has just sat in a chair or if it's just a bag or some other object. So we actually have up here on stage with me this IoT camera. And I need to be able to train this camera to be smart enough to know, does this chair have a bag in it or is it a person? So to build this, I'll show you my screen quickly. I'm starting here in the Azure Cognitive Services. And this is the Azure Custom Vision Service. Now, I've been able to use the service to power our IoT camera. You can see here I've actually uploaded a few sample images already. Some of these are tagged that a person is present in the conference room, and other ones are tagged that it's empty. And what's powerful here is that without having to write a single line of code, I can click this train button and train this model. So now when it sees new images that it might have never seen before, it can accurately predict, is this a person or not? Now, bringing this back to IoT, I don't want to have to send the video feed from my devices constantly up into the internet. So what I can actually do here back on my screen is in Azure Cognitive Services, I can click this export button and export this model to run directly on the IoT device itself. So now all of that processing can happen there. So that's exactly what we've done. We'll test this out. I've deployed this working model to our IoT camera that's up here on the stage. And Matt, you can notice it's not yet registered. There's a person there. There's nothing happening.
Yep. Okay.
But if you'll go ahead and take a seat.
And I noticed there before I go that you had it was a Docker file. So that's a Docker container running on that device.
That's right. Yeah, so it's all powered through containers.
OK, here we go.
So he goes ahead, he takes a seat, and you'll notice right away, as soon as he sits down, this device has detected that there is a person, the lights have flashed, and it lets us know this is not just a bag, it's not a wet blanket.
Thanks.
This is a person.
Thanks, I'm not just a bag. Thanks very much. So, awesome, very cool.
It.
What do you think? So this analysis was able to happen even though you weren't connected to the internet or that camera wasn't specifically. So it all happened locally on the device, and it seemed like it was pretty easy to train the model, as you showed. So it becomes accessible for developers of all skill levels just to get started with.
Yeah.
Now, once we've got all these intelligent devices powering different solutions, how do we manage it? Because the operations person in me is a little bit worried. It's a nightmare to manage all of these connected devices and keep them up to date.
Yeah, honestly, traditionally, IoT management has been a struggle because you're adding all of these new devices into your business. How do you keep it from just becoming a tangled mess? So the last thing I want to show you here is another solution in the Azure IoT platform. And this is Azure IoT Central. Became generally available today. And this is a fully managed SaaS solution that allows you to connect, monitor, and manage your IoT assets at scale. So in our offices, we want to provide snacks for our employees. So we've got a few refrigerated vending machines around on different floors. And what's awesome is here in IoT Central, I can actually get a single view into all of the different devices that I've configured in my business. And if I wanted to get more specifics on a specific device, like I want to know what's happening on floor 2, I just simply click into that device. And now here I have real-time insights into the health and temperature of this device.
That's awesome. Cool stuff. Lots of useful information for people to glean from those specific devices. Now, that's a great example of managing and monitoring device health. But what happens if a device has an issue? Can we automatically take action?
Yeah, absolutely. So IoT Central has this cool functionality called rules. And I can specify rules for my IoT devices. So for our refrigerated vending machines, I want to know if the temperature ever gets too high. So I can come in here and go ahead and set a rule. And I can specify a high temperature alert. Now I can choose if I want this alert to run on all devices of this class or just on this specific device. I can even define the condition here. So you'll notice I've set a condition already that says if the temperature goes above 60 degrees Fahrenheit, I need to fire an alert. The food's getting too warm. I might food poison all of my employees. And the last element here in my rule is the action that I want to take. Now, I actually have a few different options for actions here. I could do something as simple as write an email. Or I could execute serverless workflows or run serverless code in response to any of these rules firing. So that's actually what I've wired up here. This is a serverless workflow that will run whenever a vending machine gets too hot. It's going to automatically post a message to our operations team and let them know that a device needs to be serviced. I can then create an incident in Dynamics 365. And then I also have some logic here to continue to track that incident to make sure if it doesn't get resolved, I can escalate it and make sure everything's taken care of. So this means now that my device health and management can trigger automatically without any human intervention. So hopefully you can see that from the silicon to the cloud to IT management, Azure has really provided a fully featured solution that allows me to work with IoT and AI in a productive and secure way.
Awesome. Thanks, Jeff. Thanks for joining us today on the show and making IoT real. It's always a pleasure to have you.
Yeah.
Now, how can people go and learn more?
So that Azure Digital Twin service that I showed you earlier is available now in preview. You can get a dev kit for Azure Sphere, also in preview today. And you can try out any of the technologies I showed you at any of these links shown behind me.
Awesome. And of course, keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest tech updates. Subscribe to us on Twitter. Thank you so much for watching. Bye for now.